You, well, if you have kids, you have to watch a lot of animated movies. Some of them you tolerate and you just kind of make it through, or you fall asleep in the theater while you watch them, which I've done on many, many, many occasions. But occasionally there's a little jewel that shines brighter than the others, and the parents love it as well. How to Train Your Dragon is one of those.
I don't have kids, and my wife and I adore this movie.
Amazing.
It's a great movie. I love this movie.
So excited about the second one. We have the stars and creator of the film in our studio. Please welcome America Ferrera, Jay Baruchel, and and of course, director Dean DeBlois.
Good Lord.
Thank you. And Jay, you've been here before.
I have indeed. Yeah, thanks for having us again.
Good to have you back. Thank you guys for being here. Yeah, like I said, the first movie was so much fun for parents and kids, and we're seeing from the advance trailers and all the scenes so far, this one is going to be the exact same way, man.
It's even better. Yeah. It's really, really incredible.
Yeah. Hey, when it comes to casting for voices, I mean, do you have auditions, or did you know right away, the hiccup has to be, I know Jay's voice, and or were there auditions?
He had no choice. I was there before him.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, Chris Sanders and I took over the directing and writing of the first movie 2 years into its three-year production.
Oh, get out.
So it was an 11th hour, Hail Mary when we came through and kind of reconceived it from page one.
That's but a good Hail Mary.
We had an amazing
Thank
cast.
Thank you very much.
We had an amazing cast, so I couldn't have done better.
Who else was auditioning for your parts then? Do you even know?
Oh my gosh, I have no idea. Lesser men,
clearly. Well, your passion for the material is evident in the fact that there's obviously the TV series as well.
Yeah,
and you're voicing that.
We do indeed. Yeah, it's been so cool. That's the thing. It's like a lot of people have been asking us like, what's it like coming back to these characters after the fact? And, in between the two movies, we've been doing the TV series. And so there really hasn't been a period over the past 7 years where we haven't been playing these characters, sort of like it's just another day at the office for us. It's just kind of like she said, like, all we do is talk into a microphone.
Yeah.
And then over the course of 3 years, a bunch of incredibly talented people make this beautiful work of art that we're allowed to lay claim to, I feel like I stumbled into my Star Wars.
Well, I don't think you could extract any one of you and have it be what it is.
Thank you.
It's a truly collaborative effort, and now you have additions to it, some stellar additions.
Cato Blanchett. Kaelin. Yeah, he's not in an octagon.
Cato Kaelin.
How'd you get him?
The ultimate house guest.
That's right.
He paid them.
He was at my pool house.
He was at your pool. He thought he heard something hit the air conditioner.
That's right. No, I think you mean Kate Blanchett.
Yeah. One of those K's, yeah. And I guess it's the cat is out of the bag, so to speak, now that she is your Hiccup's mother. But the truth of the matter is that you have an Oscar-winning actress. How did you approach her, Dean, for the
At the Oscars?
Yeah. Oh, really?
No kidding.
In 2011, we were there. We were nominated for Best Animated Film and Best Score, and I saw her in the cocktail mixer right before the awards started. So I walked up to her. I said, I wrote a part for you in How to Train Your Dragon. And she asked me about it. I told her it's this Jane Goodall sort of Diane Fossey-like woman who's been living with dragons for 20 years. And immediately, in her beautiful dress and hair done, she started adopting the mannerisms of somebody who might have lived among dragons. And,
oh, nice. Wow.
And she said, I'm not doing anything at the moment. Send me the script because the first movie is a huge hit at our household.
She's got three sons, I think,
three
right?
Sons.
They're all little fanatical
who
for
Who won
it,
the but. Oscar that year for the Best Animated?
Toy Story 3.
A lesser movie.
A lesser movie.
I'm by lesser man.
Yes. It's a great movie, but I you guys should have won it. I mean,
I agree completely.
Yeah, we did mention that.
Is it sort of a weird thing, though, that process? You talked about all the hours, recording. When you're now that you have the image, you know what everything looks like a lot easier. But is it still weird to be recording this way and recording dialogue that way? How do you as an actor compensate for actually not being on a physical set? And
well, in some ways, it frees you up because it doesn't matter how ridiculous you look. You just got to get it through your voice. But
okay.
it's you know, I love when I get to record with someone else. I got to do a session with Jay. One of the first scenes you see our characters together was a joint session. And those are always more fun because you have each other to play off of. But like, speaking of Jaimin, my character, Astrid, confronts Drago, his character. And when I saw the movie finished, I thought, oh my gosh, that is not how I would have played that scene if I knew, you know, that's how scary Jaimin was being. But I guess it worked out in the end.
It makes you more ballsy, I guess. Yeah.
Well, the movie's going to open up on the 13th, and cannot wait. And we actually have a screening this weekend. Kay, should I give some more?
I think so. Yeah, we're doing family.
We're going to do it at the Rave in Philly, and it's going to be 10:30 on Saturday. So let's give away 3-4 packs, and I'll hang on to some more to give away tomorrow, too, at 215-263-WMMR, and we'll set you up with those. Thank you guys for continuing this story.
Thank you so much.
It's great.
Thanks
we love so it so much and can't wait to see
it. Thank you for having us.
You bet. Good luck with everything. Surfer Jay Baruchel and Dean DeBlois. We're going to take a break. We'll be back in just a moment. Stay with us, gang.